In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of muscles that do pelvic anterior tilt. What kind of movement is that? Anterior tilt is you move pelvis this way. Okay? This way is anterior tilt. If there is anterior tilt, there is posterior tilt, which is this way. Okay, I'm going to explain muscles that do anterior tilt. Let me explain one by one. So this is anterior view. First muscle is this one. This is rectus femoris. Rectus femoris. This is part of quadriceps. Okay, quadriceps. But rectus femoris is only muscle among quadriceps that does anterior tilt. Why is that? Because rectus femoris originates from pelvis. You don't see its attachment, but imagine rectus femoris attaches around here. Other three muscles do not attach to pelvis. They attach to femur. Thus, rectus femoris is part of quadriceps, but that also can do anterior tilt. That makes sense. Next one is this one. This is tensor fascia lata. Tensor fascia lata. It's slightly tiny muscle, but this can do anterior tilt. I will show you these muscles later for profile view. Okay, this is better view for a first part. Next one. This one. This is very long and thin muscle. This is sartorius. Sartorius. This muscle also can do anterior tilt. From this picture, I'm going to explain one more muscle. This is it. This is iliacus. Iliacus. This muscle originates from inside part of pelvis. This is very rare muscle. I have a question. How about this muscle? This is psoas. Doesn't psoas do anterior tilt working with iliacus? My answer is technically yes, technically not. Let me explain that. This is psoas, and imagine psoas and iliacus run inside part of pelvis. Thing is, psoas does not attach to pelvis. This guy attaches to lumbar spine. Lumbar spines. This guy doesn't attach to pelvis. So technically, this guy cannot move pelvis. It's just because it doesn't attach to pelvis. But psoas kind of unites with iliacus around inguinal area. Then these muscles are called iliopsoas, right? Iliacus can do anterior tilt. Psoas unites with iliacus. So when these two muscles work together, maybe psoas can do anterior tilt. Then there is another example. When psoas contracts, that can bring lumbar spines to kind of extended position. That can do extension for lumbar spines. In extension position, what's going to happen to sacrum and pelvis? They tend to go to anterior tilt. Again, psoas doesn't move pelvis. That moves lumbar spines. Tendency is that goes to extension. When lumbar is extended, tendency is pelvis goes to anterior tilt. So my answer is psoas can technically do pelvic anterior tilt, but that cannot directly move to anterior tilt. Does it make sense? Anyway, this is psoas. Then I'm gonna explain other muscles. This is gluteus medius. By the way, this is tensor fasciae latae. Gluteus medius is about this one. It's very broad muscle. Let's divide gluteus medius to two parts. This is anterior fiber. When anterior fiber contracts this way, that can do anterior tilt. Vice versa. If posterior fiber contracts this way, that can bring pelvis to posterior tilt. So, anterior fiber can bring pelvis to anterior tilt. Simple enough. Then, deep to gluteus medius, there is gluteus minimus. Then, same like gluteus medius, anterior fiber of gluteus minimus can bring pelvis to anterior tilt. So, gluteus medius and minimus. It depends on which fiber contracts, okay? Then, I will explain one more muscle groups. Next one is back muscles. I mean, which one? Which back muscles? There are numerous back muscles that can do anterior tilt, such as erector spinae. Erector spinae, or like martifidus. Martifidus. Why? Because when back muscles pull sacrum and pelvis this way, this kind of rotational force is applied to pelvis. What is this movement? This is anterior tilt, right? So, back muscles can bring pelvis to anterior tilt. You can find this information from anatomy book. Like sartorius can do anterior tilt, rectus femoris does anterior tilt, iliacus does anterior tilt. So you can find these muscles on anatomy book and kinesiology book. From now on, it's gonna be my hypothesis. So basic thing is hip flexors also can do anterior tilt. Think about it. Tensor fascia latae does hip flexion. Iliacus does hip flexion. Rectus femoris can do hip flexion. So basically, hip flexor muscles also do anterior tilt. That's very simple, right? All right, I will show you two adductor muscles. This one is adductor longus. Adductor longus. This one is adductor brevis. These two muscles also can do flexion. They can do hip flexion. So, muscles which do hip flexion also can do anterior tilt, correct? These two muscles are hip flexors, so they might be able to do anterior tilt of pelvis, right? I haven't seen anatomy books that say adductor muscles can do anterior tilt, but logically, these muscles can do hip flexion. So, why not? They can do anterior tilt. So this is just my hypothesis. There should be researches about adductor muscles and anterior tilt, but I haven't seen them. So let's say this is just hypothesis. However, I think it's quite possible. So in this video, I explained anatomy of muscles that do anterior tilt of pelvis. Easy way to remember is hip flexor muscles can do anterior tilt. It's very simple to remember. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.